to do an end of the year 2019 recap and give you like some stuff we're leaving in 2019, because this year was ridiculous. Half was good, and then like October, all that stuff went out the window. So if you are ready for this video, stay tuned. Oh, and if you notice the lighting is a little bit differently, I got a ring light for Christmas, so my lighting will be better. We're shooting better quality videos all 2020, decade long. So to do a recap over 2019, I had these amazing opportunities for DC. I got scholarships. I started working at Chick-fil-A. I went to Mexico, and unfortunately, I had to bury one of my close friends. And it kind of took a lot to get through these times, because I mean, it really was not one of those years where let's talk about how popping I was and how banged out. It was one of those years where it's like, let me humble you and remind you that you can be on top, but you do need to also realize a couple of things. Like, for example, I had to come to terms with people grow apart from each other. It's not just, oh, you're gonna see signs of you growing apart and you're gonna grow apart. No, it might be so small that you not even notice it, and then when it actually happens, you're like, oh dang, like, we're no longer friends, we're no longer gonna be communicating. Like, that totally sucks, and that's perfectly okay. Like, you have to be comfortable by yourself. There's no other way of putting it. If you want to do something, you have to be okay with being like, I'm no longer gonna be going out, I'm no longer gonna be hanging out with this person, I'm no longer gonna be doing a lot of stuff that I'm used to and comfortable doing. Like, in high school, I used to have a whole bunch of friends, and we used to be all clicked up together, and we've been together since middle school, so when we got to high school, it was still pretty much the same energy. So now I'm in college, and you got to start over. And not to say that starting over is a bad thing. Sometimes we need to hit that reset button, but on top of starting over, that means you have to reintroduce yourself. You have to re-figure out your environment, figure out who you are as a person. And that can be challenging at sometimes, even scary for a lot of it. But don't go into 2020 feeling insecure about these changes. Don't feel like, oh, well, it's been negative this whole entire time. Why does the year changing mean that I'm going to be any better? I'm going to tell you why. Because when you claim it, that's what it's going to be, okay? You claiming it means you're speaking it into the air and you're going to work towards it. That doesn't mean it's going to come instant. A lot of the things that people want takes work, but a lot of people are not willing to put in the work to get there. And it takes more than just, I want to do it. It takes research, it takes lack of sleep, it takes focus, it takes time away from things that you actually genuinely want to do sometimes. Like, when it comes to YouTube, I want to be a scriptwriter. That's what my major is in. I have to research doing internships, I have to do homework, I have classes. But on top of that, I also do YouTube, which is fun. I have a lot of fun doing it. So I want to learn how to step my game up. I want to learn what can make my editing quality better, what better videos I can get out to you, how can I be the best YouTuber I can be for my audience and for myself. But on top of being a YouTuber in college, you gotta be organized, and that's what, unfortunately, I lack. I lack organization. I lack continuing on with a schedule, and that's one thing I do want to take in 2020. I want to be organized for my viewers and for myself, because nothing is accomplished from disorganization. Nothing. You cannot film, edit, post, promote, do homework, and have a social life all in the same day. That's kind of madness, in all honesty. It takes a lot to be a YouTuber. It takes a lot to do the things I want to do. And one thing I want to leave you off with is giving you ways that you can start off the year correctly. So to start off the year correctly, I know I talked about this in like older videos, and I kind of want to do an updated video. Start your year off with a vision board. I want you to make a vision board of things you want to accomplish throughout the year. And as you do it, check it off. Sorry. somewhere where you can see it. Put the board on your focus. Let it be on your phone screen. Let it be on your iPad, your whatever. You need to see this board and work towards these goals every single day. Just because you glue it or tape it on a board does not mean it's going to happen. You need to do the work to get there. It's kind of like saying, I want 1,000 subscribers, but I'm only going to post once a month. It's not going to happen. You need to put in the energy, put in the work to get to your 1,000 subscribers. By the end of next year, I plan to have 1,000 subscribers and 1,000 followers on Instagram. And I'm going to get there. But that takes consistency, that takes time, that change. That means I have to change how I do things and how I move. And I'm okay with that. That's one thing I can say this year taught me how to do. You have to be comfortable with being uncomfortable. There's going to be situations where you're like, dang, I thought we were going to be different. I thought stuff was going to be easy. I thought stuff was going to work out. As you get older, you'll realize I need to know more about myself. I'm learning more about myself. I'm taking on more opportunities, more challenges. Stuff is getting a little crazy, but I'm going to be okay with it, if that makes sense.
A lot of people,
I feel like we do the best thing for other, like, new year, you know, me, I'm going to do all these things. I'm going to stay motivated. I'm going to do, and then y'all don't do it. It's so freaking crazy. Like, for example, this is a real common one. I'm going to start going to the gym. You'll say, I'm going to start going to the gym, or I want to lose weight. And you do it for just January. February, you fall off. March, you forgot all about it. It don't exist. That's not how these things work. You have to keep at it. You have to keep on top of yourself. I feel like as a society, we struggle with consistency. Because we want everything to move fast. Like, if we don't have instant results, it's never going to work. And that's not how things work. That's not how life works. We need to be patient. We need to be okay with falling and be okay with growing at the same time. You need to separate yourself from people and things that don't make you happy. If it doesn't make you happy, don't do it. Like, if you realize college ain't for you, because college ain't for everybody. I'm going to be very quite honest when I tell y'all that. I'm not saying don't go, do right by yourself. That's why I want you to be very clear on. If you realize college isn't for you, research jobs that you can do inside the field that I guess you're interested in. Or get a trade. That is very much an option that I don't feel like people pay attention to. You can definitely get a trade for some of the things that you're trying to do. And if you realize there's no real trades I want to do, college ain't for me, you can work. You can work your behind off until you come up with an idea. Like, in today's society, you don't even have to have real talent, like, to do much. You could literally be a YouTuber. You could sell lashes. You could sell bundles of hair. And you will make a good enough income if you save correctly and budget correctly to be successful and happy and comfortable. And that's what we're taking into 2020. We're going to be business owners. We're going to make boss moves on our own. We're going to be comfortable with being alone. Because I feel like sometimes we're used to hanging out with people and their energy kind of rubs off. Like, if they're lazy, you'll slowly get lazy. But if they're constantly doing something, then you're going to constantly feel like you need to do something. Like, be very conscious about the energy you let around you going into this new decade, this new year. I don't want to just put the emphasis on this new year, but the whole decade. Like, we're going into a whole nother part of your life. The roaring 20s. We gotta be able to be bosses out here. We can't depend on nobody. Codependency, we don't know her. Blackfishing, we don't know her. Insecurities, we don't know her. We're going to be going to counseling. We're gonna be starting those projects we say we were gonna do. We're not gonna be procrastinating. We're gonna be on top of it. The time to be like, oh, they didn't teach me this. Why don't I know how to? We're teaching ourselves, okay? That's what we're doing at this point. We're not depending on nobody. Again, we're not depending on nobody. We're going straight to the bank. We're going for all of it. We're gonna claim stuff and we're gonna attract it and we're gonna work for it. We're not going to sit around and be like, dang, that sucks. Like, dang, No, life is hard. It's very hard. But we're going to get through it, okay? We're going to get through it. We're not going to be sitting around being like, oh, I wish I could. I would have did this. No, we're going to do it, okay? Write down your goals. Write down what you want to do, what you want to be, what you want to attract. And go for it. Full throttle. Put your energy and your whole mind into it. We're not going to let stuff you see on social media get you down, or that one person you can't stand. Oh my, she always got to talk about me. Like, we don't know what drama is. We don't know her. We haven't seen her for a minute. Like, y'all know who drama is? Because I don't. We're leaving her alone. We're focusing on ourselves. We're going to boss up all decade long. Like, the time to be like, oh, I wish I would have did this. I don't know how to do it, so I can't do it. No. We're going to do research. The time is now. We're living a lot in 2019, okay? We're living in insecurities, blackfishing, attention seekers, negativity of any kind, whether it be social media, influencers, products, friends, family, whatever. We're leaving them. We're leaving it. We're bossing up. People. We're going to meditate. We're going to counseling. We're going to start doing hobbies. We're going to try new foods, new trends, new different things to better our life. We're going to start journaling again, because I feel like once you write your feelings down and what you're thinking, you have a clearer mind. And I feel like I started that at the top of the decade, like middle school. Fell off in high school, college, barely exist. But I want to get back into that. We're going to be taking time for ourselves. Again, we are taking time for ourselves. There's so many times where me personally, or I feel like people give so much of them, so much of their time. Like, oh, you want to go do this? Let's do it. If you need me to give you this, I got it. Not anymore. We're not going to be doing this anymore, okay? We're taking time to take care of our self-care, our self-love, and that doesn't just mean we're going to go buy a face mask, we're going to get our nails done, we're going to plan, we're going to schedule, we're going to be organized, and we're going to stay organized. I have two agendas now, one for school and one for YouTube, so I will be planning my videos and planning accordingly to what I plan to do during the week. Because I plan to be on a consistent schedule in 2020, and I plan to stay on a consistent schedule, or I will let you know if plans change. We're going to be organized. We're going to take time to get to know ourselves and be comfortable being uncomfortable. We're going to take on new opportunities, new challenges, and we're going to ride the wave out. Whether you fall or you succeed, it's up to what you put into it. That's all there is to it. If you put in your time, your money, your energy, you will be okay. And if you come up short, it's a learning process. I learned that, hey, you can't do this, you can't do that. If you want this, you got to do it a different way. Viewers, I want to give you guys the best quality content that I can on a weekly basis at a time. We're going to start doing more trendy videos around here. We're going to start doing different types of content. And I hope you enjoy the ride, because, like I said, we're bossing up in 2020. We're going to be doing a whole bunch of different things. Okay. So, going into 2020, I want everyone to have a clear understanding of what they want to do. I need you to make a vision board, a list of goals, and I want you to put it somewhere where you can see it every single day. I want you to be very focused about what you want and move forward. Because it's okay to change what you want to do, but it's not okay to fall off, become complacent, become lazy about it. So I need you to make a vision board. I need you to write down your plans. I need you to actually make those plans, like schedule it in, start talking to people about what you want to do, and be consistent. Once you do all four of these, everything should usually fall into place. You'll feel happier, you're gonna feel a lot more in control of your life. But that's all I wanted to do. I will see you in 2020. New year, new me, new content. But if you like this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll